the ancient prophets in the Old Testament prophesied that these men would come later.
Right, before. Are you talking about before?
No.
Before Matthew, Mark, and Luke.
Like, okay, I'm gonna give you an example. You know about Prophet Elijah, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what prophet declared that he would come back in the latter days? Which prophet declared that? That the Lord would send Elijah the prophet again.
Is he the one that Jesus rose again?
No. I'm asking you, what prophet? You don't know the answer.
Well, what is it?
Well, that's the Old Testament.
I'm interested. It's not Lazarus.
Because you believe in the Old Testament, and you're starting to say because man wrote it. I don't know what your view is, or because you're saying that man wrote it. That are you saying that has no credit? It has no merit?
No.
Because a man wrote it?
No, not at all. I'm saying that there is more room for error.
There's more room for error?
Because it's been translated. Does that make sense?
Right.
But
the whole book has been translated.
That you're
even the
is green, and someone else will say it's olive.
Right. The olive is a derivative of green.
Right. So that's what I mean. So. Right.
But this is where the spirit comes in, because the spirit will give you
the answer.
Yes. But you have to have the father line of that.
So he will give you the guidance that you need to.
Like it says in Romans, the 8th chapter, the Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of the Most High God.
I get it. I get it. That's why I'm just saying, you know what I mean? Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, the Old Testament has less room for interpretation, but like you said, all of it is a derivative of green.
There's errors in the Old Testament as well.
Of course.
We know how to pinpoint those errors.
Because if it's all from the Spirit, it's going to lead us to those pitfalls.
And you're going to, you believe that it will be directed toward the man
or woman or whatever, with that's not connected to the Spirit of the Lord, would have that pitfall that they wouldn't see.
Right, so they would fall for the lie.
And fall for
the
simple what it says. Right.
Right, and those that have that connection will find the truth.
Right, because
it'll be that inside of you.
You might not have it because
you can't describe it like that.
You can't be taught. It's a feeling that you just know.
Right,
it's
like that.
Something just tells you.
Right, it's that inside that you can't explain. Feeling. Right, you can't explain it because it's greater than.
Okay.
So does that make sense? Greater than, but you know this is one of the five.
And what's funny about it, a lot of it is just common sense, because it's not going to contradict itself somewhere, you know, it's going to ring through the whole book. So you adjust yourself and your belief into understanding the whole book as it is written, and then not as it is, but as the Spirit is, versus just as it is written. That's how you find it out. If God says he hates the Edomites, he's not going to one place in the Bible. He's not going to say he loves the Edomites in another place in the Bible.
Right, so it's about studying and learning and making yourself knowledgeable.
Yeah, but it's, but
the Spirit, is only given to a certain group of men that can teach it.
Right.
That's why when the Lord spoke parables, it was to confuse the multitude of people on the shore, but it was only to his disciples.
Right.
It's the same thing to this very day.
Right.
The Lord is only dealing with a certain select group of men, and he's going to reveal his mysteries and prophecies to those men, and they in turn teach it to the men who are meant to receive it and understand it.
It's like if you speak a different language to me that I don't know,
I wouldn't understand it. Yeah.
I got it.
That's it.
I got it. Thank you for answering my question.
No problem.
It was genuine, interest to know your belief, not in any way to say that you are wrong or I'm right.
We have to tell you one more thing. We did you a favor. We were supposed to talk to that man, not to you. If that's your husband, or if that's your man or whatever.
I know where the hotel is.
It was hypothetically saying.
Is he gonna be my husband?
I don't know. That's up to God.
Alright.
You have some questions, brother?
Very powerful statement,
Oh yes.
So educate me.
Educate you about what?
Where your belief system comes from.
It's pretty self-explanatory. That's something anyway. Self-acceptance.
Think about it, like, you're not white, right? The color of your shirt. One soul.
Because that's what people think, because they've been taught that this is what the Bible actually says. Well, described.
That's pretty cool. And realistically speaking, I'm very open to what you guys are talking about. It's the region of the world where everything happens. He was not pale.
Right, man. Even though there's pale people in that region now.
Now.
Right. Wow. But they did, like we were just saying, they did say that they were those people, though. They did say that they were the people that image comes from, that, you know.
Yeah.
So if we're white, and we're the Jews, we tell you that we're the Jews, and we're in that land, then that makes sense. If you don't do any study, if you just understand a simple level of things, but when you understand deeper, you do a little bit of research, you'll know that it's, go in the Bible and find it, then you link it up to everything else.
Well, thank you for the education. Take care, guys.
Alright. Yeah, you.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, you know what I'm saying? I'll come back for a few weeks. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? I was thinking, like, I watch videos and everything. I've learned a lot, but when I, like, kind of go into the scriptures, like, the way you asked that woman who said this scripture about Elijah, like, I wouldn't be able to answer that. Yeah. That's when I've been studying, trying to dig deep into the scriptures, you know?
Right, right.
So, you know what I'm saying? I've been watching the things she sent me, the elders, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, last week, I was reading up on, like, the genealogy of Yahweh Shai. So, I was trying to break down, like, I was trying to see what you say. So, in reincarnation, he was Adam, then he was Solomon, and
there was somebody else in there, too.
Right, that's the first chapter of the New Testament, right?
Yeah.
So he was the son of
right. But that's a simple way to kind of, I'll just read that right there. Matthew 1:1, it says, the book of the generation of Yahweh, I'm going to read it for you, real quick, of Yahweh Shai and Mashiach, the son of David, who was the son of David.
Son of David?
Yeah. The son of Abraham was Isaac. You know? And then it goes down and you'll see where, when you start picking up the characteristics of those people, you'll see where the characteristics fit them. Like even as Adam. Matter of fact,
what you looking for?
Basically the link that the word is in Yahweh Shai.
That the word is in Yahweh Shai. John 1.
Yeah, that's what I have that one. Let me read the precepts to that. Matter of fact, it says it right here. This is St. John chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with the Most High, and the Word was the Most High. But I'm going to read it verbatim. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word, in the beginning, meaning Genesis, right? In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended not. That's talking about, to understand Genesis, the first chapter, it's the same thing. That light was the wisdom coming to the earth to create the whole thing. But those spirits that the Most High created the spirits. And those original spirits created the earth. The first spirit that he created was Yahushua, which by his word. Well, when he said, and God said, let there be light, but he didn't do that then. When he manifested it all, he manifested the spirit to create the earth. I'm trying to think how to put that in the scripture.
What?
How the Most High created Yahushua first. I forgot the break there, and the possibility.
Let me bring it up.
One more thing, I want to go off topic, but right? I heard a brother say that the elect man also helped create.
Right. Because when you look up that word God, Genesis, the first chapter, the word is Alahayim. Which Allah is a singular form of God, Alahayim is a plural form of God. So those were the first powers, existing powers. Those were the first powers. And then, so the Most High created those first powers, and then it says in Psalms, I believe it said that we are God.
Right, he is talking about the elect man.
Right.
It's on Colossians 1 and 15. Who is the image of the invisible power, the firstborn of every creature?
Right.
For by him were all things. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. He is before all things, and by him all things consist.
Right.
And he is the head of the body of the church.
Right.
Who is the beginning?
Who's the head of the body of the church? Yeah. Yahushua. Right? But who was all things created by or named and was consisted of? Adam. Adam got the name, everything, and do all that when he came to the human form. But it was the spirit of that first man was called Adam because the physical flesh was made of the ground, but the spirit was of Yahushua. Is it going there or no?
Start at 12. I'm going to go back up to 12. It says, giving thanks unto the Father, talking about the Most High, which have made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who have delivered us from the power of darkness and have translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption.
When he gave us the light, and I don't mean in the Genesis, but when he gave us the light or the word or the breath of life, he gave us the wisdom to understand that we're going to have an understanding of this world. We're going to have an understanding of this world. You know, that's why the Statute of Commandments pushed that. And Adam didn't have that written down. Adam just knew, which they were plural Adam.
Right, always like a nation.
Yes. But then Adam, that was every man was an Adam. Every man and every woman in the real beginning was that. Until he created Eve to be joined up to Adam. There were women also, but they were Adams too until they made that union possible to repopulate the women.
So wait, what's the difference between, you said there were women that were Adam?
Right.
We're all the women that were Eve?
When they are joined the woman unto the man to repopulate the earth through intercourse.
So there were no sex before that point?
You can say no. You can say no. You
know, it was men.
Just enough people out. And we weren't meant to die before that either, but that all came, when you start putting the big picture together, you'll see how the Most High had all that happen to lead up from Eve going off, and not Adam, Eve going off, and then all of this life that transpired from there, coming back to when he brings us back to him. So now we have a repopulation system. We have a teaching system, which is by trial, you know, of what happens when how life is when we do the right things, and then this life when we don't do the right things. And if the basis man was the bucket, you know, all the way that this play out.
Right, so initially they were doing right.
Right.
Correct. So there was no death, right?
There was no death. Yeah, everything was good until Eve.
When you're going to the kingdom, you're going to be doing right already, but yet there's still death, though?
Because
no, there's not going to be any death.
Right.
What's going to happen is...
Well, yeah, you told me you are...
You're going to just... Your spirit just going to translate. You never die. Your spirit never dies.
Your flesh will...
You know? You'll have the body to be able to just...
gonna come back as a child though.
Yeah, you gonna come back, but you gonna come back you.
Yeah.
You gonna come back you again.
Same you.
You know?
So like, okay, you say, so like, kind of like look at the same, but you get a new body, so you don't really look the same.
Well,
that's a mystery that I don't know.
Yeah, that's something that's, when we get in the kingdom,
I see what you're saying,
you know, but you still gonna come as you, you know?